Bibi has hacked me, and she will only let me go once I play her game. But while we are at it, I might as well review her. I will continue with the God Tier 3 star DPS as I promised with the next video. I'll jump straight to the point, Bibi is the best 4-star servant in the game, hands down. The only one who even comes close is Mash, because the devs clearly have a thing for Kohais. She is one of the very few servants who is a legit option both as a DPS and as a support, though she is better as a DPS. Now before we go into her kit, please remember to like and subscribe if you haven't already, if you want to see more FGO content like this. And join our Discord if you'd like to talk about FGO with fellow players. Bibi's skills each do their own thing, but they are all individually very powerful. Her first skill is Media Lily's whole kit. First she will remove every debuff on a servant, then she will heal said servant for 3000 HP, and to finish it off she will give them debuff immunity, so they'll be safe for a while. But if they do get hurt again, the cooldown on all this goodness is only 4 turns. Now, I'll talk about her third skill before her second. Self-Modification X is the same skill Jalter has, but while it is Jalter's strongest skill, on Bibi it's her least important one. That speaks more to how strong Bibi is, however, because this is still a crazy powerful skill. With such a huge star gathering buff, along with some decent star generation from her 4-hit quicks and extra, Bibi will have no problem critting for impressive damage. But the main use of this skill, rather than direct damage, is to further increase her already impressive NP gain and allow her to easily loop her NP, to the benefit of her team. With that said, let's talk about her second skill. Simply put, her second skill is Busted. It is the best stun in the game. A 6-turn cooldown for a 100% stun rate which is not restricted by traits or mental debuff resistance, and even removes evade and invincibility buffs on top of that. Now, since it does cap at 100%, one would think that enemy debuff resistance can sometimes block this, but this is where the rest of BB's kit comes in. For passives, she has some debuff resistance of her own, but most importantly she has debuff success rate up to bring that stun rate up to 110%. As well as 10% arts up to boost her NP damage and NP gain. Passives are often underrated by newer players, but never underestimate the power of a buff with 100% uptime. BB's NP is amazing. The free NP 5 means this will always deal respectable damage despite her only buff being 10% arts up, and its 5 hits will guarantee you get some refund out of it. But the real selling point of this MP is that every time you use it, everyone gets 20% battery. This is incredible, this makes your supports spam their MPs even more, which in turn will make Bibi spam her own MP even more. It's amazing synergy that pushes her team's performance through the roof. And as a cherry on top, it even reduces enemy debuff resistance, making her stun have at least 120% effective stun rate most of the time. Not counting the fact that you will often get overcharge on this as you should be firing it last in an NP chain. With OC3, which isn't hard to achieve, you will be able to bypass the greater majority of magic resistance and core of the goddess passives. BB's gameplay is the art's dream. Use your heal whenever you can, your stun should be used off cooldown unless you need to delay an enemy NP, and self-modification if you want to use a brave chain. Use her NP every time you can, and try to achieve art chains every turn. For team comps, just make sure you have hard defense, but any 2 art supports will work. Mash brings a second mixed deck, but she brings huge defensive utility. Waver has overall great synergy with Bibi, and the stun on his NP greatly benefits from her overcharge effect. Merlin brings hard defense and really benefits from being able to spam Garden of Avalon more than he already does. Jhon is known for her poor NP gain, but with Bibi's battery it's very easy to keep the enemy unable to deal damage between Jhon's NP and both of their stuns. Tamamo is just always good in Art's teams, and her cooldown reduction brings great value to BB's high power, low cooldown skills.
Artoria Caster is, quite obviously, the best servant in the game, and pairing the best 4-star to the best 5-star makes for a great team. As it turns out, the two have great synergy.
There are times, however, where enemy riders hit so hard that it becomes really risky to bring casters. These times, however, are the ones where BB can shine as a support, especially when paired with Jhon, as while she is no Merlin, she will still bring overall strong utility, while relying on her neutral class and her big, huge, humongous HP stat to keep herself safe. Before getting into her weaknesses, a very important topic must be addressed, BB's class, Moon Cancer. Moon Cancer is a class that brings strengths and weaknesses alike. While its class advantage against Avengers can be hugely impactful, its overall neutral matchups, the lack of the 10% damage bonus the other classes in its triangle have, and its weakness to rulers severely cripple its offensive potential. At the same time, however, having the same star weight as casters, while lacking a rider weakness, makes them a straight-up upgrade over casters as supports in most situations. And in BB's case specifically, she doesn't suffer from her low star weight as a DPS, because she has a high uptime star gather skill to make up for it. Class advantage against Avengers rarely comes into play, but is hugely impactful when it does, seeing just how hard Avengers can hit. And one last thing that sets Moon Cancer aside from the other classes is that their death rate is so incredibly low that they are basically immune to instant death. While it does not matter often, when it does, it matters a lot. Now, for BB's weaknesses, her first weakness is actually the flip side of her greatest strength, her 20% battery on NP. It forces her to fire her NP last in an NP chain, often forcing bargains between her battery or powerful overcharges like those of Merlin and Jhon. It gets especially bad if you have Tamamo, as you will always be wasting some battery regardless of which order you pick. The ideal strategy, therefore, is to alternate different NPs on different turns, while looking for Arts chains to double down on the 20% battery. Keep in mind, however, that it is possible to circumvent this weakness to some extent if the support's NP level is 2 or more, by using BB's NP to further boost their overcharge. In an Arts chain, BB can turn a 160% bar into a 200% one, going full circle and turning this strength-turned weakness into a strength all over again. Her second weakness is her very low attack. While her incredible synergy with both the Black Grail and another ending makes it easy to increase it by 2,400 points, it will still negatively impact her damage. I really recommend giving her gold attack foes, as they will go a long way in boosting her damage, and if you like doing challenge quests you'll probably be using her a lot. Her third weakness is that everything she does is single target. She can't heal everyone at once, or cleanse everyone at once, and most importantly, if there are multiple enemies, she cannot stun everyone. That is unfortunately something that cannot be fixed. But it can still be used to the player's advantage in multiple enemy scenarios by stunning specific enemies in order to synchronize enemy NPs and block them all together with Jhon or Merlin. Her last weakness is that, if used as a support rather than as a DPS, she doesn't bring enough healing and lacks hard defense. This kind of forces you to run her alongside Jhon, which is not a bad comp by any means, but it is still quite limiting. Now, who competes with BB? While she is quite the unique servant, once we isolate her niches as a neutral class arts DPS and a non-caster arts support, we can find servants who fulfill the same role. Let's begin with her DPS competition, as that is her most prominent role. The first servant she'll be competing with is the upcoming 4-star ruler, Astraea. BB has overall better NP gain due to having better quick cards as well as having 2 quick cards instead of 1. And her 20% battery being tied to her NP means it'll be used more often than Astraea's own battery. When it comes to star generation, BB's cards are slightly better, but Astraea's second skill and NP make it so she will be making a lot more stars in practice. However, Astraea's damage is massive and BB simply cannot compete damage-wise. Even at NP1, she will outdamage BB before her interlude and without her power mod. Not to mention having two busters means her critical damage potential is much higher. Astraea's ruler class means she also takes hits much better than BB, despite her significantly lower HP. However, I did say that BB is the best 4-star, and while Astraea is an incredible servant 100% worth pulling for, I cannot wholeheartedly say she is superior to BB. The reasons for this are two, the first one being that most of her buffs only last one turn, meaning the damage gap between her and BB is not as big as it may seem, and her kit is very selfish. Sure, she brings a respectable amount of stars, but her utility pales in comparison to BB's arsenal of team battery, guaranteed stun, healing, debuff removal, debuff immunity, and debuff resistance down, which ultimately makes BB's whole team have better survivability, and often allows for more aggressive support choices that would otherwise be too risky against certain enemy bosses. Moving on to BB's second competitor as a DPS, we have none other than Sherlock Holmes. And for the purpose of this comparison, we will be accounting for Sherlock's buff, as it will be coming to NA, not too long after this video is released. Sherlock's NP gain is on another level. His arts cards are the second best arts cards of all art servants, and the rest of his deck is also quite strong. While his active star generation is just a little below that of BB, he has a star burst to more than compensate for that. Now, Sherlock has higher damage potential, but here's the deal, offensive servants with non-damaging NPs are inconsistent. There, I said it. You either compromise your brave chain by throwing your NP into it, which forces you to choose between giving up your buster first card bonus and not buffing your first buster at all. Or you NP on a different turn, putting yourself on a 2-turn timer to find a good brave chain, and looping with 1-turn buffs is not that effective. And the damage potential isn't even that impressive at the end of the day. Especially because you can't run the Black Grail, and your best option for raw damage becomes either another ending or Victor of the Moon depending on your deck. And after going through all this trouble, what are you left with? A deck with a single buster, on a servant who's supposed to crit for the entirety of his damage. This is just sad. Sherlock has impressive team utility as well as impressive survivability, but he does not bring enough to be a reliable support and his damage is too inconsistent to compete. He gets outperformed not just by BB, but by Astraea as well. BB's last competition as a DPS pick is
China.
Ladies and gentlemen, meet Sherlock Holmes done right. While he has the similar consistency issues to Sherlock, and his NP gain is overall inferior to BB, he does everything else right. His damage potential is a lot higher, he has two busters, his NP brings very powerful defensive utility, and his skills bring even more utility and survivability to the team. Now, is he better than BB? In many cases, I would say yes. But BB can still outperform him depending on the enemy, especially against those with AoE basic attacks, aside from obviously being better against Avengers. Actually, one might even consider bringing both if the enemy is a rider, as the Emperor's stun will benefit greatly from BB's debuff resistance down. For her support competition, I was going to include Jhon, but then I realized that BB kinda requires Jhon to be used as a support, so it doesn't make sense to compare them. Let's move on to BB's rival to the best Kohai prize, OG Mash. Mash is really busted, and I consider her to be the second best 4-star. She will get her own video, but BB is better, because she is more flexible and because she works as a DPS. She is definitely not as good as Mash as a support, however, but her battery and her stunt give her better synergy with Jhon specifically. So only bring BB as a support over Mash if you are running Jhon. BB's last competition is
China.
Reines denies class disadvantage, while also bringing defense up, which allows superior caster support to be brought even against casters. This directly competes with, and greatly diminishes BB's support niche, but there will still be cases where you need the tankiness of Jhon, and in those specific cases, you should still bring BB, because they have much better synergy, but in any other scenario, Reines is better. Now that we've discussed practicalities, let's get to technicalities. For BB's skills, there are various opinions on the matter, but I would go with 2, 1, 3. The reason for this is that her stun needs a high level to be reliable, and the lower your cooldown is, the more enemy turns you can skip. Her heal should also be maxed, as reducing its already low cooldown will greatly improve its effectiveness. Her third skill can be left at 6 or 9 if you are low on materials, but I still recommend maxing it as the uptime and damage will make a difference. Those who follow me already know by now that I absolutely love the Black Grail. And BB is basically built for it. Usually, NP looping comes at the cost of giving up arts chains and decreasing the party's NP overall NP gain by focusing solely on the DPS. But in BB's case, the party will actually gain more NP the more she loops, so the drawback is nullified. And between her huge HP pool and her first skill, the HP cost is going to matter less than nothing. As always, however, there are options. Sign of Smiling Face and Cute Orangette will give significantly less damage, but in exchange they will greatly increase BB's already high NP gain for even more looping. Honey Lake is the best limited CE of the next 2 years, and an underrated option I should have included in my Ishiwakamaru video. As it's quite easy to maintain 100% burn uptime on enemies by giving burn command codes to your supports. The Ignore invincibility can come in handy, but BB can already remove it with her stun, so it's not as big a deal, and the damage drop from the almighty Black Grail is very noticeable. Aside from those, all the CEs on the screen now are valid options. The thing to look for are a full attack spread and a combination of arts up, NP gain up, NP damage up and crit damage up. If you're using BB as a support, go with the usual suspects, which are being shown on screen right now, and don't forget to give your backline ideal Holy King, if you have it. On my last video I received some feedback on my suggestion to not give Ushiwakamaru starting NPCEs, and I'll give the same recommendation for BB and explain you my reasoning. Starting NPCEs are very strong for farming, but in challenge quests they should only be used for fast clears. They bring significantly less permanent buffs, or sometimes none at all, just to get your first NP out earlier. Now not only that NP will be much weaker, what do you gain from breaking the enemy's first bar early, provided you even achieve that? You gain a buffed enemy boss before your supports had the time to catch up and use their own NPs to get you rolling and ready to deal with the enemy properly. For command codes, I suggest going with anything that provides NP gain, stars, or defense, in this order of importance. NP damage CCs, however, are a valid option for her buster card. Grails are mandatory. Just kidding, Grails are never mandatory, but they bring incredible value to BB. Her HP stat will be even bigger than that of most SSRs, and her attack will remain low, but an increase is always an increase. I strongly recommend, however, giving your BB gold attack foes. Her low base attack stat means she will greatly benefit from the flat attack increase, and she is definitely strong enough to be worth investing in. Fate Grand Order has always had a tradition of giving players strong welfare servants, and with BB they really outdid themselves. A servant able to trivialize most challenge quests, with free NP5 and easy ascension materials is a blessing to experienced players and a total game changer to new ones. Even if you miss her rerun, with her main interlude she will be permanently available, and even at NP1 she already has her stun and battery, which are the most important parts of her kit. So getting her and raising her should be your top priority. I love discussing gameplay, so leave your comments below about what you think of BB, and please tell me who you'd like to see next. And if you liked the video, please like, subscribe and join our Discord server. Link in the description. See you next episode.